Hello, today we're going to do a code. The code is going to be the distance between two numbers. Okay, so these, basically think about these objects as two numbers. Now think about a function, like the function of a flash program, basically having conditions within the function. And these conditions could either run on updates, it updates every loop through time, or it does it once on load when it loads up the program. So basically the update function, if there's a condition like these two characters kiss, the conditions operation goes through, all the operations of the condition goes through. But if they haven't kissed yet, they don't go through. So here's basically, hold on, let me adjust this here for a second. Here's the code to the object. This is the milk object. You can read this. I'll allow you to read it. I'll help you out here. This is the load function call. It's an event that occurs when the object is loaded. Flash has a load function call called onclip event load. It's a loading operation. It's when the object is loaded on the program, all these operations go through. X is the horizontal position. So lowercase x equals underscore flashes underscore x, which is the horizontal position for any object on flash. Y is the vertical position. Okay, so I love is going to be the name of an object that's going to be loaded through attach movie clip. The call, the function call of flash called attach movie clip. I love is going to load an object from a library, and the object is called love. So it's going to load it from the library onto the screen. The on enter frame function is an update event. As you can see, I wrote down right here to make sure that you know that. On update, right here says it. So on update, this is standing for his variables and operations and functions or function calls equal to flashes function calls. So that means that it's basically emulating flashes calls and flashes variables, but I convert them to a regular variable that you can understand, basically. For an example. So IT is going to be a variable that's going to be equal to I love you. This is the object. Remember, I equals love. I love. This is the object that was loaded on there. The name of it is love. So it's going to say I love you. A text is going to be, a text box is going to be equal to IT. So it's going to carry that out. But that's only going to happen when the heart disappears. When the heart disappears, then it will happen. That's a condition, basically. When the condition goes through, the operation occurs, basically. So LX equals the last position of the horizontal position. This condition is asking whether or not it touched. Touch is going to be a variable that's going to be equal to one of Flash's hit detection calls. So the hit test is basically, it says right here, hit test is basically to check whether or not the male character and the female character touch each other. When they touch each other, they're basically kissing. So when they touch, this condition goes through, and all the operations that this condition is supposed to make goes through. The last x position, if it's equal to x, which is right over here, if it's equal. This will only happen when they're touching each other and when they kiss, when they basically kiss. So S equals true, then it equals false. So it doesn't, this condition doesn't go through more than one time. So I'm going to show you why S equals true. S equals true because it allows the condition to go through once and then it stops. So S actually stands for stop. So it equals true, then it equals false, so then it, the condition stops. It doesn't go through anymore since this S is there. So that's basically it for now. Let's try out the program. Okay, there it goes. I love you, just like I said. Now I'm going to show you the heart. And then we're going to look at the distance function, or the formula to the distance. Alright, so let's start off from where we left off. Okay, so here we go. Let me explain what the onEnterFrame function means and what it does. It means on entering a frame in the rate of time, which flashes frame rate stands for. In other words, every event in time within its code is updated through its operations. Okay, so you understand that part, right? Alright. HP represents horizontal position of this heart's object. Let's fix that little error there. This heart's object. HP must decrease every event in time by 1.5 because it must adjust back according to the growth of the heart. Size represents the size of the heart. Okay, now put this up here. The reason why size must increase every event in time by 6 is because the heart grows substantially. Alright. Get this part over here. The vertical position must decrease every event in time by 13 because this heart, or this heart, moves up quite quickly, and the, and in programming, the vertical position of an object when decreased moves up rather than down like when it increases. So basically, what I'm saying there is that in programming, the vertical position of objects basically moves upwards when you decrease the value of the variable, which represents the vertical position. So when you decrease the value, it moves upwards, and when you increase it, it moves downwards. So let's read the rest. Let me explain what a condition means and what it does. A condition basically means, in programming, that if something is true in the condition, an operation follows after. So, provided the comparison of the condition is true, the calls, operations, or operation goes through. So that's basically it. Alright, so let me test this program really quick. Alright, it says I love you, she kissed, the heart went up and disappeared, and I love you went through. So basically that's what this code does. So let's see the raw code. This is the raw code to the, basically the formula of the distance, which we use for that program. Okay, let's put it right here. Alright, this is a complementary operator. It gets rid of floating point numbers like 1.5 would be 1 if you use it. So it gets rid of 0.5. Like in this test right here, this prompt. In this prompt, it says minus 10 from 25 divided by 10 equals 1, which it really isn't the truth. It's supposed to be 1.5. So this operator right here, complementary operator, gets rid of the 0.5. This right here, it gets rid of that. The reason why I did this is because in my games that I develop, my program for games I develop, needs to get rid of that number. But in the future, I'll develop a code which is very simple, just taking this piece right here without the complementary operator to make a distance code and get rid of these over here. So it will give me 1.5 in this test right here, this prompt, instead of 1. So this has been a Secret Truth video. If you like this video, please press the like button and give me a like. If you have any comments about it, give me a comment about it and let me know what you think about the program. Thank you and goodbye.